This is Tim, and welcome to the Math League YouTube channel. Today, I'm going to be doing three number sense questions that came in by request. And this is the perfect time to do that because we're going to be starting a new number sense challenge on April 1st. Let me tell you a little bit about the number sense challenge, and then I'll get into these three problems. The way the number sense challenge works is it is a 10-week program. Every Thursday night, if you're in the US, or every Friday morning, if you're in East Asia, we will be doing a one-hour program that consists of checking in, taking a number sense test, submitting your answers, and then after that's all done, I spend the rest of the hour going over a lesson where I cover as many problems as I can from that day's test. So you can, as soon as you're done taking the test, you can watch how I do some of the problems. We go over some tricks. We start off week one of the number sense challenge, talking a little bit about strategy, talking about how to get through some of the first 10 problems or so. And then each week we build up and explain additional problems. So by the time we're done with the 10-week challenge, I'm explaining problems at the very end of the test. We do have prizes for the number sense challenge as well. So it is a 10-week challenge. We take your top 8 scores. So you can discard the 2 lowest ones, or if you aren't able to make it to one of the contests, that's fine. We take your top 8 scores, and then we give out prizes at the end. First place prize in our previous challenges has been up to $300 worth of Math League credit or a $200 Amazon gift card. So the prizes are pretty substantial. We'd like to invite you to join our Number Sense Challenge. Again, that's next challenge starts on April 1st, and it will be done before Elementary National Championship in June. So hope to see as many of you as possible there. Let's get right into these questions then. Number 55. So first off, I'm not going to get into too much detail about how to do number bases. The thing about this one is there's a trick, right? So you're going to see a lot of these where we're asking you to convert from base 4 or base 8 into base 2, or we might ask you to convert from base 2 into base 4 or base 8. The thing to keep in mind is that if you are dealing with numbers in base 4, each one of those will split into 2 digits in base 2. If you're dealing with numbers in base 8, it'll split into 3 digits in base 2 because 8 is 2 to the power of 3. Conversely, if you're trying to go from base 2 into base 8, you'll group the digits 3 at a time starting from the units digit and turn those into base 8 numbers. If you're turning from base 2 into base 4, you're going to group the numbers 2 at a time starting from the units digit and turn those into base 4 numbers. So what we're going to do is take each of these numbers in base 4, right? We've got a 2, we've got a 2, we've got a 3, and each one of them is going to become a 2-digit number, and we just have to turn it into the 2-digit base 2 number. The number 2, if I turn it into base 2, is 10. So I've got another 10 here. If I want to turn the number 3 into base 2, it becomes a 11. So there's our answer, 101011. All right, let's move up to number 62. So the way I do this is I'm going to use FOIL, all right? So it's basically 12 and a fourth. So let me actually write it out. 12 plus a fourth times 12 plus a fourth. All right, what does that give us? Well, 12 times 12 is 144. Then I'm going to take 12 times a fourth and another 12 times a fourth. A fourth of 12 is 3, right? And I've got a 3 in the middle and a 3 on the outside. So that's an extra 6. And then the final thing is a fourth times a fourth, which is 1/16. All right, so 144 plus 6 is going to be 150. And then 1/16, I just write that here. Now remember, if you're taking this as an online test, what you're going to do is write 150 space 1/16 as your answer. Okay. All right, and you're going to see a lot of these in the fourth column of the test where you've got two mixed numbers multiplied together, and you're always going to FOIL them out. All right, so you're going to take the integers multiplied together. That's going to give you some of the integer part. In a lot of the cases, you're going to see that if I do this product, the inner product here, 12 times a fourth, it's going to be an integer. The outer product, 12 times a fourth, also an integer. So you're just basically adding those onto whatever 12 times 12 is. And then the final thing is just multiplying the 1/4 times the 1/4 to get the 1/16. All right, number 65 is kind of interesting. Check this out. I'll actually prove the trick to you and then I'll show you how you use it as a shortcut. All right. So what you want to notice here is that 23 is 20 plus 3 squared. And then I've got 28, which is 30 minus 2 squared. Now, the key to this is recognizing that I've got a 2 and a 3 in both of them, right? 20 plus 3, 30 minus 2. So in both cases, I have a 2 and a 3. And one of them, the 2 is multiplied by 10. The other one, the 3 is multiplied by 10. And then whichever one isn't multiplied by 10, we've got it as a unit. And then one of them is added together and the other one is subtracted, right? So you'll see that there are several different problems you can create using the same type. Right? I could do something like, if I wanted my numbers to be 7 and 6, I could do 70 plus 6 squared and 60 minus 7 squared. All right. So I'll come back to this in a little bit and I'll show you how to use it. Once we've developed the trick, I'll show you how to use it on this one. All right. So what you want to do to see how the trick works is FOIL it out. All right, 20 plus 3 squared is going to be 20 squared plus 2 times 20 times 3 plus 3 squared. Then I've got 30 minus 2 squared, which is 30 squared minus 2 times 30 times 2 plus 2 squared. All right, let's take a look at the middle terms. 2 times 20 times 3, that's 40 times 3. This is 120. 2 times 30 is 60 times 2 is 120, but I'm subtracting it. Wait, I added 120, I subtracted 120. Those all cancel out. So take a look at what we've got now. I've got 2 squared plus 3 squared, right? 9 plus 4 is 13. And then 20 squared plus 30 squared, that's the same thing as 2 squared plus 3 squared, only with a couple zeros at the end, right? So that's 1300. So 13, 13. So the trick here is, once I know that the numbers I'm using are 2 and 3, all I have to do is take 2 squared plus 3 squared, write that down twice. Okay, so let's come back up to this example that I've shown you at the top, 76 squared. My numbers are 7 and 6, right? 70 plus 6, 60 minus 7. So all I have to do to get the answer to this is I'm going to take 7 squared plus 6 squared, right? That's 49 plus 36. And those of you who've been to the Number Sense Challenge, you've learned the trade-off, right? 49 plus 36 is the same thing as 50 plus 35. That just makes the calculation easier. That is an 85. So I write down 85 and I write down another 85. And that's my answer to this problem. Just like 13, 13 is the answer to this problem. And that's how it's done.
Hi, everybody. This is Tim. Hope you're enjoying our videos. If so, you know what to do, like, subscribe, turn on notifications, all that sort of thing. But what I'd really want to invite you to do is to send us an email at media@mathleague.org. Tell us which problems you'd like to see us cover next in our video series. Take care and see you in the next video.